Hey everybody, it's the OMAD Dad. Welcome back to my YouTube channel, a channel that is dedicated to living the OMAD lifestyle or eating just one meal a day. Well, it's been a little while since I've posted. We've been crazy busy at the restaurant with the holidays. I'm sure you understand. I'm sure all of you have been busy with your holidays. I hope you've had a great holiday season, no matter what you celebrate. The year is almost over. It's coming to a big climatic end, and pretty soon, before you know it, it's going to be 2019. I can't believe it's going to be 2019 soon. Well, regardless, I'm glad to be back with you guys doing another video. I hope you've had a really great holiday. I'll tell you, just putting things into perspective, we were just crazy busy at the restaurant. I can't even fathom how our little hole in the wall was able to put out as much food as we did, and it's kind of alarming actually. But as we get closer to the new year, things will slow down a little bit and be back to more of a normal schedule, so I won't have to go as long in between posts. But I thought I would make this post today, probably my last one of the year, mostly because I think the timing of this will be right. Usually around the holidays at this time, this week especially, people are taking all of their holiday gifts back that they don't want, back to the mall and back to the different stores and exchanging things. So today I want to talk about fashion that keeps you fat. When I was creeping up to 235 pounds, my heaviest weight, which was not done intentionally, by the way, whenever you get... You sometimes get this moment where you discover just how far you've let yourself go or how far things have come. And a lot of the time, we know that it takes a while to put on weight. We know and get out of shape. We know it takes time. But psychologically, it seems like it just kind of creeps up on us. But I think mostly that comes from because of the fact that we miss warning signs or we ignore them, right? And I think fashion and what you wear is a perfect example of this. When I was getting heavier and I was getting bigger, I was more and more uncomfortable. My back hurt, my body ached, I was tired all the time, my joints hurt. And so really what I was trying to do is to get myself to a level where I was comfortable and I felt okay. And the truth is that there's nothing really you're going to do to get yourself there other than taking the weight off. You're just, you know, delaying what you're supposed to, you know, you have to do. But as what I would do is I would wear a lot of what I call my fat man clothes, okay? I'd wear these little nice stretchy pants, big baggy shirts, big baggy little hoodies like this sometimes. And especially during the winter here in Massachusetts, we have a very cold and somewhat long winter, so you want to bundle up and get warm and be cozy. And you know, there's ultimately nothing wrong with jogging pants like these, but really what they are known as is loungewear, and that's what they're intended for when you're lounging, or in other words, when you're in bed, you want something comfortable on you. So what would happen is I would get used to wearing stuff like this, even my work uniform, my chef pants. There's a company called Chefwear that I used to go shop through that would mostly just have stretchy pants. I don't know why. They do have the ones that have belt loops on them, but they were really comfortable and I'd wear them to work. And the problem with that is you aren't aware of how much weight you're putting on because there's so much stretch in them. So I would have an event that would come up where I would need to wear a suit, or maybe I would have to dress up. Maybe it's a date, or maybe it's a special family function or whatever. And I'd go to put on my suit. I'd go to put on those pants I have, or my sport coat or a dress shirt, whatever I was going to do. And it wouldn't even be in the ballpark. And that would be like a slap in the face. Okay. It's like either I have to get dressed that day, or I'm just trying on an outfit for maybe an interview that I have coming up or something is going on. And I quickly saw how I wasn't even in the ballpark. I had put on so much weight and it was just eye-opening for me. And the only clothes that I had that fit me were those ultra big, you know, stretchy pants that kind of tried to hide the fact that I had put on so much weight. So one thing, now that I've taken the weight off, that I've become more conscious of doing is making sure I'm wearing more form-fitting clothes. And it's not for something of a vanity nature. It's not for me to kind of show off the fact that I've lost weight. It's the fact that it will keep these clothes, if they're a little bit tighter, if I overdo it and I don't stay on track, it's a constant reminder that, hey, you need to stop what you're doing and you need to go figure out if you're doing something wrong, get back into your plan, whatever. But I wear, as soon as I get up and I'm done, I've done sleeping, I wake up and I put regular pants on, I put a belt on, and I make sure it's nice and tight. And I know that if I overeat or if I overdo it, it's going to be tight and it's going to hurt. There's a point to that. And on top of it, you also have the psychological effect of getting up in the morning, getting yourself dressed, making yourself look good, feeling good about yourself, going out and dressing the world. But it'd be the same thing with shirts, form-fitting t-shirts. This prevents you from hiding the fact that you have a shitty diet or that you're not, doing something to actively control your weight and control your health. So that's my two cents. I mean, ultimately, these pants and these outfits here are best to be used for what they're designed for, and that's loungewear for when you are lounging. You want to be comfortable when you are lounging and when you are sleeping, particularly so that you can get a nice deep sleep and feel good. But when it comes to your waking hours, make sure you've got some nice tight clothes on. Make sure you've got form-fitting clothes. And this will definitely get you to keep you in check. And one more thing too, when I was going losing my weight, I bought jeans that were a size smaller than what I was at the time, and that was the motivation. And they were pretty expensive, and that was the motivation for me to lose the weight because I wanted to get in them. And the feeling that I had from finally getting in there, finally fitting into those, it was like a trophy for me. And I'm happy to say that now those same jeans, if I don't wear a belt, will fall off entirely for me. And they're slim fit too. I've never in my life have worn slim fit jeans. But again, this is all part of it. So when I talk about the fashion indirectly making you fat or that you should dress casually, believe me, I'm not a fashionista. I'm not saying you need to buy very expensive clothing, but buy and wear form-fitting clothing for your waking hours. Use a belt. If you're having a hoodie or something like that on, great for when you're outside. You come inside, take it off, get comfortable, but at the same time, make sure it's relatively tight to you so that, and snug, there's nothing wrong with that because that will keep you in check and that will keep you honest because these pants around here can stretch like you wouldn't believe. Okay? It can go from this to this kind of a waist and you won't even know it until you go to put on a nice pair of clothes and that's, or you go to the doctors and then you realize, oh my God, I'm 40 pounds overweight. How did this happen? It happened because you weren't looking at the warning signs. You weren't watching. So this is a little food for thought today for when you guys are out there and maybe returning some of your clothes, or maybe you got some clothes for Christmas and or Hanukkah or your whatever holiday you celebrate or lack thereof. I hope you can get some benefit from this video. I'm going to try and post another video before the year is out, but I may not be able to. I'm not sure. I still have a little bit of work to do at the restaurant. It's still pretty busy. So I hope you've had a really great 2018 either way. I thank you for subscribing and checking out these videos. And I've got a lot more content to come. And 2019 is going to be your year. It's going to be our year. We're going to do this. And I want you to join me on this OMAD journey. And I want you to have the same success that I've had and many, many thousands of other people have had too. So that is it for me for today, folks. Thank you. Have a great day, and I will see you very soon.